everyone, and welcome to Beyond Focus TV. My name is Angie Daniel, of course, and I am your hostess. Tonight's show is a continuity of a conversation that we had with a young man that's within the Haitian community. He's doing really, really well. He's trying to bring together the Haitian community music to the mainstream world. We're going to take a short break. When I come back, I'll introduce him. Back to Beyond Focus TV. If tonight's your first time watching, we are here every Tuesday, channel 68 on cable vision at 10 p.m. If you have any great ideas you'd like to share with the community, you are welcome to get in touch with us. At the end of the show, it will be our phone number and our website. You can call us back. My producer will be back in touch with you. To go back to what I was saying, that we have a young man within the community. His name is E. Unique Cabral. He is the representative from H Factor Project. Welcome, sir.
Thank you for having me. It's a blessing.
It is.
Definitely.
Well, you know what? One other thing that I wanted to talk to you about is that from the last time you were here, if anybody else was watching, to understand that we started talking about like what the H Factor project was all about. So briefly, can you tell the community what it's all about, and then we'll continue.
The initiative of H Factor is to create a genre that represents the Haitian market mainstream, where we take all the Haitian styles of music, compa, zouk, toubadou, racine, mix it with hip hop, jazz, classical, and you know, just to basically create a platform. In a lane, should I say, just like reggae music, hip hop, reggaeton. Even when reggaeton started, people thought it was a fad, and you know, it went on to you know to do great things and stuff. So, I feel there's a void in the Haitian community, mainstream, and there's a lot of work that needs to be done to take it to the next level. And H Factor was created to actually make that you know become a reality. H Factor stands for History, Heritage, Humanity, Harmony, Heart.
Okay. You know, one of the things that we've talked about, and it's how music kind of create a uniformity within community. How do you feel like with H Factor bringing that idea together? How do you feel like we're going to blend in?
Well, the concept of H Factor, you know, a lot of the foundation of the music is some of the Haitian music and French music, but at the end of the day, it's created in a way where it actually brings and mix all cultures. And you know, you may hear some salsa in one of the tracks, you may hear some calypso, reggae, you know, classical music. And the thing is, and even with the language, even with when H Factor first originated, I would go back and forth with the language, like Creole and English. And you know, certain times I'll throw in other languages there, in and out. But you know, the main objective is to actually, you know, once we create that platform, be creative enough to keep it interesting, you know, because the bottom line is, if you look at hip-hop have evolved from the time it started, you know.
Yes,
different styles of hip-hop, and, you know, there's hardcore, you know, there's, you know, a lot of singing, R&B mixed with hip-hop. So, you know, it's basically a matter of being creative and creating something that have, you know, a good hook and a good beat, you know, to take it to the next level.
You know, one of the things that we were talking about is how to get people to understand on a level of what Haitian music is all about. I mean, besides the history, because we have a serious history within our community, is understand other people to understand, getting other people to understand the history behind each of our music. For example, you know, you have Racine, which talks about, like, all about history, what people went through, where they are at. And it's a different way of teaching people and getting people to understand the story of our lives. You have compa, which is pure dancing music, but certain Haitian musicians have a way of creating the history within compa, but mostly it's a dancing music. One of the things that I'm noticing a lot, we've always had it, it was just not as huge as it is right now within the Haitian community, is the jazz Haitian jazz musicians.
Yes.
How do you have any Haitian jazz musician within the H Factor family?
Oh, definitely. As a matter of fact, there's a song that I created called Sexy, and that one definitely mixed the jazz. And it's funny because you actually hear the compa in there, but the jazz feel is all in there, you know? And it definitely the few people that have heard it before, because it's going to be the next single that I put out. They were kind of caught off guard because, you know, when you explain it to someone until you actually hear it or actually hear different versions of what H-Factor is, then you get the bigger picture, you know?
So H-Factor in general, like I know we've talked about it briefly. H-Factor is ideas of music.
Okay, well, H-Factor is music, and it's actually mixing our Haitian music, French music with hip-hop, classical and all that stuff, and at the same time, H-Factor is also a conglomerate of people that comes together as a production, and at the same time, network, because a part of H-Factor project, H-Factor family is also part of
Yeah, we're going to talk about H-Factor family, because it's one of the things that I really want people to understand your concept and idea of how you're trying to bring forth.
Yes.
This whole community.
Yes.
I mean, and it's taken on. It's taken on, like the idea is taken on. But I wanted people to understand what H Factor stands for in general, like behind, like you have different artists.
Okay.
You have different group of people.
Okay.
You have different productions. You have everyone working together as a group, as a unit.
Unit. Exactly.
As a unit, right?
Exactly.
And to bring it forth. We're going to take a short break. When we come back, we're going to talk about H Factor family and the last event that you've had, how we're integrated together. We'll be right back. Welcome back. We are here with E. Eunuch Cabral. He is the president of H-Factor Factory. Before we took a break, we were talking about like the idea of the project in itself. Mm-hmm. But within it, you've created a family where you just had a last meeting.
Yes.
Which to me, I have to say first and foremost, congratulations.
Thank you.
It
thank
was
you.
Really beautiful.
Thank you. Appreciate
I love the combination of people that you had there.
Yes, thank you.
You know, it was just like, you know, a Haitian event.
Yes.
You had different people performing.
Yes.
Can you tell us a little bit about what it stands for?
Well, number one, like, you know, I've been to a lot of events and stuff like that, and I wanted to put an event together where, you know, everyone's comfortable, everyone, you know, that family, having a good time, mingling, network type of vibe. And the thing is, like, when I speak about H-Factor and talk about representing the Haitian community, the bigger picture is creating relationships and so we could take it, so we could, you know, take it to the next level.
Because
the thing is, like, yes, you know,
we
a lot of
Haitians,
our
yes,
and a lot of people from our community will be, you know, singing or rapping on these songs. But I want mainstream artists to be able to also sing on these H Factor tracks and stuff like that, and bring that whole type of relationship. We had Dominican artist Jen Marie perform, and we had also Andrea.
Yes.
She was there. She was there and she performed, and you know she did a wonderful job. So it's about creating relationships and actually creating something that can open up the market so people could embrace our culture and our music.
And I think it's really important. For me, it's being able for others to understand. Like,
exactly.
I get questioned a whole lot about, like, why is the show not in Creole?
Mm-hmm.
Yes, I am Haitian, but it's not all that I am. I'm not just Haitian. Like, I am Haitian in the mainstream world, the regular world. Like, everybody else gets to talk about situations that are affecting our lives. It's not just, you know, getting people to understand what this H Factor stands for. It's not just like a Haitian guy that have Haitian music. You understand? It's like bringing people together. It's about time that we kind of like go out of our ways to blend in.
Exactly.
You know, instead of blending, you know, outward. Like, just getting everybody to understand what we're all about. And we are one people.
Exactly. And you know, the thing is, in the music business in general, like when you look at Facebook or so many artists, they may have money and they're trying to make it. They're trying to do so many things and nothing's happening. At the end of the day, the key thing, I don't care what you do, the key thing is it's a numbers game. How many people you know, how many people knows you exist to make the decision, they like it or they don't, or they're going to buy it or they're not going to buy it.
Yeah.
And that's it at the end of the day. So the thing is, if you could expose yourself to 1 billion people and you get 5% of that,
Yeah, that's true.
So it's really that simple. So it's not really rocket science. And if you have enough people supporting, and it's so funny because H Factor Family is it's going to create a network outside of just the internet.
Yes.
See, and then the thing is, you know, the internet is a great venue to actually promote something. Mm-hmm. But the thing is, the H Factor Family, each individual have their own thing going on.
Yes.
And their own network. Yeah. We're just coming together to do a power move where we could actually move mountains.
Okay.
And that's the main objective. Because the thing is, we want to be able to create an institution opposed to just a whole bunch of people just trying, okay, we come together, we party, whatever the case may be. We want to win as H Factor Family. If we decide to move that mountain, we're going to move it.
And we can.
Bottom line. Exactly.
It's not because we can't. I mean, I talk about the different ideas of how people bring forth Haiti.
Yes.
To me, it's like after the earthquake, you know, the earthquake happened for so many reasons, and I talk about that all the time.
Mm-hmm.
It happened for a reason. It's all these people didn't just lose their lives for nothing.
Yes.
Something had to happen for everyone else to be aware.
Exactly.
Of the state of that country in itself.
Yes.
And having people like yourself who's doing such tremendous work,
mm-hmm.
within the community, just bringing forth ideas, getting people together to work together as a team is part of that. I mean, we understand right now we are in a transition of being part of the world. It's not, we're not just like a little country off the field, like
exactly.
The whole history happened. Yes, it did happen. The earthquake happened, but how do we move forward? How do we get to blend into the rest of the world without being told that we are we're part of the worst hemisphere,
exactly.
The poorest country? Let's create a different idea and bring that forward, you know, which is what you're doing right now.
Yes, and it plays a very important role because changing Haiti, it's going to take many things to bring about that change. So the thing is, when you look at the Jay-Z's of the world, the P. Diddy's, Russell Simmons,
mm-hmm.
we can create that out of our community and create those conglomerates just like they have.
Yes.
And with that type of power, with that type of access, imagine what we can do. It's the
mm-hmm.
same thing, you know? And we can empower ourselves and be self-sufficient with creating things so we could do bigger things and move bigger agendas and then work together in a sense of how we say H Factor Family and do whatever we need to do, you know? Because the thing is, it's bigger than just music.
Okay. I wanted to kind of like, you know, briefly talk about like your history.
Okay.
Like how you became E-Unit. Like, I know you... We've talked about this before.
Mm-hmm.
I just don't
mm-hmm.
want it to mention.
Okay. Well, I mean, I've been in the business, you know, off mm-hmm. and on for a long time and stuff like that. You know, I've worked for many record labels coming up. I've been A&R, management. I produce. I write. You know, a choreograph and stuff. I'm also elected official in the 86th district in the Bronx. And music have always been my passion. No matter what I get involved in indulge in. Music is in my heart, it's in my soul, and the main thing when I think about H Factor, first of all, for me to have the idea to want to go against the grain and
mm-hmm.
come up with a new genre of music when it's so easy to just do what everyone else is doing, that's a big step to take, you know, to talk about, you know, you starting a new genre and stuff like that. So the bottom line is, it's not just about money and it's just not about just creating, you know, just music. It's actually implementing something that can help others. Because the thing is, opening that lane, you'll have other artists that want to, you know, come out and, you know, take part of the movement and create their own music. And we'll create that lane just like hip-hop. Well, just like how when hip-hop started, just like reggae music, so on and so forth. And that's the bigger picture.
Okay.
Yeah.
You know what? We're going to take a short break. When we come back, we're going to talk about, like, the impact that H Factor and within... the idea that you're bringing forth together.
Okay.
So we're going to take a short break. We'll be right back.
Off. Henry Christophe, the heroes that set the revolution off, and defeating the bone up on the park. You didn't know, but the defeat in Napoleon paved the way for United States to acquire a used part of territory from France, Louisiana Purchase, nearly double the size of America. I'm telling you, once Haiti's republic was declared, Haitian revolutionaries have nurtured freedom in other parts of the hemisphere to help liberate Hispaniola, Dominican Republic, while others continue to migrate to Haiti to escape from Caribbeans at Grenada, Jamaica, and Cuba. These events will move ya, it will move ya. So I vent for this magnificent moment in history and what it meant for people of African descent. Over 200 years of blood, sweat, and tears. If you proud, fear, throw your flags up in the air. Over 200 years of blood, sweat, and tears. If you proud, fear, yeah. Throw your flags up in the air. Over 200 years of blood, sweat, and tears. 208 years to be exact. Life ain't worth nothing without risk. It took more than heart to ignite this revolution. Coupe d'etat, boulet kai. Jean-Jacques Dessalines said, and led the people to freedom. That was the only option for this. Haiti was isolated, marginalized, stigmatized by nations of Europe and the US at best. And they even forced Haiti to pay reparations to France for loss of property and slavery. U.S. went along and invaded Haiti 1915 and remained an occupying power until 1934. You didn't know what? Haiti paid reparations between 1825 and 1922. What would you do? Sometimes your country suffers from its past as well as its triumph. But that's politics for ya. But it's time to turn the page. It's about uplifting, identifying oneself in our contemporary struggle for democracy and development the way things should be. To ensure my Haitian people their desire for dignity and self-determination. There's much work to be done to advance the vision and the value and the principles that have fulfilled the promise of the revolution. I'm making a deck more something. We started something till the day is done. One, over 200 years of blood, sweat, and tears. If you here, throw your flags up in the air. Over 200 years of blood, sweat, and tears. If you proud, yeah, throw your flags up in the air. Over 200 years of blood, sweat, and tears. 208 years to be exact. Ma changini, ma changini pour
le pays,
pour les ancêtres. Ma chang, ma chang, ma changini.
Welcome back to Beyond Cookies TV. We are here with E-Unit from H Factor Project. We were talking about the idea of how you bring forth the whole project situation and what it means to you. I mean, like, talking to you, I understand the passion. Because for you to be able to devote so much time to something, you have to be passionate about it. And if you're not passionate about it, then it's a waste of time. You have an event. You did an event before, which I attended.
Yes.
It was really beautiful.
And you can dance.
I was trying to have my
own
event. But talking about that, you have a second event coming up.
Yes, June 28th. We're having an H Factor Project event June 28th at Crystal Manor. That's 1460 Flatbush between
Glenwood. I think you need to speak up a little bit.
Yeah, that's
more, so.
Okay. Yes, we're having the next event will be June 28th, Thursday, June 28th, at Crystal Manor, 1460 Glenwood between 1460 Flatbush,
Flatbush between Glenwood and Farragut.
Exactly.
Yeah.
And you know, and again, you know, the last one was a success. Everyone came out, had a good time, and again, the initiative is to start promoting out, because you can imagine how many artists in our community, you know, artists, musicians, fell to the wayside, you know, and then, you know, they had a name, successful, and then they just fizzled away.
You should have a little poetry reading.
Oh, yes, we're going
to
do all that.
I have an idea, like I could write.
Oh, we'll give you the platform.
Okay,
well,
cool.
Because the whole idea is to promote elected officials, artists, business, people in the community who have a voice. We'll give you the platform. The thing is, you know, we just have to, you know, communicate, and you call us, and then we'll work everything out. But at the end of the day, it's to open the market and open and empower and promote our known talent and our unknown talent in our community so we could keep pushing the agenda.
And let people understand that H Factor is not just for, it's not a
Haitian thing. Exactly.
Yeah, it's not.
No,
you know,
no.
It's bringing forth, like we said earlier, there were different artists that were there.
Exactly.
There were different people who performed.
Yes,
we had a beautiful band.
Yes.
And you know, like, I'm like, okay, you know what, they should be promoted a little bit more, because
get
people to understand that they are here. So you're saying, like, if anyone have any talents, like, well, you know, like myself, like writing, poetry. I think poetry is really beautiful. Like to have a little.
The next one, we like to have you, you know, I like to hear her poetry. So make sure you'll come out and see, you know, Angie do her poetry.
Beautiful stories.
Yes.
I that,
oh, beautiful.
You know. Then you have people who can perform, who can sing. If they would like to participate.
Yes.
Yeah.
Well, if you'd like to participate, you know, in the future events coming up, you can reach me at 646-938-5031. That's 646-938-5031, and leave a message and, you know, let us know the reason that you're calling, and we'll definitely get back in touch with you, because in the future, we're also going to have auditions,
yes.
You know, for all types of artists, because we plan on having concerts, you know, all types of things to, you know, to keep the movement going and stuff like that. So, and the thing is, like, even with the H Factor family, it won't just be a free-for-all, you know, even taking part of that, you know, we go through a process of finding out what the person is about, what they mm-hmm. do, because just like I mentioned before, each one that's part of the H Factor family have their own network, but at the same time, we come together if we're promoting an artist, promoting a business to make that happen.
And I think it's really important for us to have a place where you can go and say, you know what, I know you could be my representative.
Yes, exactly.
Instead of like having
exactly.
to go. I've seen a lot of young people mm-hmm. have pictures taken.
Yes.
And their mindset that they
exactly.
could be models.
Exactly.
And either they are taken advantage of.
Yes,
like they've
exactly.
never had a chance to promote themselves or have pictures taken or have people say to them, like, you could participate in my fashion show.
Exactly.
And then you would go to the fashion show, everybody's in underwear.
Exactly.
That these are the type of things that we don't want to happen
exactly.
to our community. We want people to do right and to learn from situations. And having someone like yourself that, mm-hmm. you know, all geared up to go out there and promote the community and
yes.
promote better things. You know, where our young people can go and express themselves, whether it's through music, poetry, singing, a band. If you have any type of talent, you
mm-hmm.
can go and be part of H Factor. It's not
exactly.
just to perform in that one time. Like, how often do you have these?
Once a month.
Once a month.
Yeah, once
events?
A month, yeah. And then it's going to lead up to bigger events and, you know, concerts.
Mm-hmm.
All types of things, because the thing is, we're going to have the roster of artists
yes.
where we can throw a concert and call it a day, you know,
yes.
from bands, poetry, singers, dancers, across the board. So, you know, we're definitely open-minded. We're looking for acts, you know, and the key in this business, you know, and not everyone have talent. You know, you may be able to sing, whatever the case may be, but always remember any of the artists that's, you know, watching Beyond Focus TV, one of the number one TV show.
That's right.
That's all. Can't forget that. You have to search deep within and bring out, be extra of what you are. You
yes.
see what I'm saying? Because the thing is, you know, it's not just being able to rap. It's that something, that extra something that you bring to the table that creates a way where people want to buy your CD, want to support you and stuff like that. There's so many artists out there.
Yeah.
So you have to, you know, create something that's, you know, that's different, something that's fresh, something that's new. So the thing is, for your artist that's looking for something new, something different, this is your opportunity because
mm-hmm.
the business is cluttered.
Yes,
and you know that.
Yes,
and now
yes.
with the internet, someone could go on the internet, millions of artists.
Yeah. Yeah.
So the thing is, you know, sometimes you want to, you know, try something different and fill it out and see, you know,
it's
and give it a chance.
Though.
Exactly.
It's a scary thought.
It is. It is. I mean, record
thought.
Companies, you know, it's not the same the way things used to be anymore. And they, even the record companies on Facebook trying to promote artists and doing the same thing that any, you know, individual who want to promote themselves, they taking those same lanes. But the only thing, they still have more money to make it happen. Exactly.
You know, one of the things that you just mentioned is how to bring something new.
Exactly.
And I think passion.
Mm-hmm.
I've noticed a whole lot. Like when you're doing something that you're passionate about,
yes.
that you really love and you really enjoy doing,
mm-hmm.
whether it is for yourself or for community in itself.
Yes.
If you bring out the passion within you, I think you'll do a better job at it. And I would say to the public, it's not just to be the next leader, the next singer, the next promoter. It's just being able to be part of, you know, a family
exactly.
that's creating something that's beautiful.
And when you're doing something, people can see, you know, like if you're speaking, like when you know, watch any artists and stuff, it transcends
yes.
and you feel them
yes.
and stuff like that. Yeah, passion.
Yeah.
So Yeah, so it's definitely big. Something we need to keep, you know, addressing and pushing, and a lot of artists need that molding and shaping, and to teach them or to educate them about certain things that they in their mind may be confident about, but you know, outside looking in, you know, you could address those situations and mold and shape them so they could actually be better performers.
So you're gonna have this event every month. This is the end of
month.
Our show, you know.
Yes,
like they tell me to wrap up.
Yeah, no problem.
So if there's anything else you'd like to say.
Well, I'd like to say one more time, if you'd like to reach us, for future events, 646-938-5031. And, you know, and mention that you're interested in being part of the H Factor Project movement. We take it from there.
Yeah, once a month.
Focus, once a month. Yeah, you know.
Well, this is the end of our show. Thank you for watching. Hopefully, I'll see you next Tuesday, same place, same time. And keep us in your mind and call us if anything. All right, see you then. Thanks a lot. Bye-bye. Thank you for being here.
Thank you.